Hello, and welcome back to Throwback Thursday on 7-Day Gaming. I am your host, the Insomniac. This is Secret of Evermore. So, we had a little hiccup while I was running after the last episode. And that little hiccup was that I ended up accidentally collecting a piece of armor that I didn't want to. I wanted to show you guys where I got this. So I'm just gonna go do that now. Even though you won't be able to see me actually getting it, clearly, because I already have it. Pay more attention. By the way, the grinding that I was doing wasn't all that terribly much. I got the specials unlocked for this weapon. I didn't think I was gonna do that, but yeah, it'll make things go quicker. Besides, I want to explain what the different specials on this weapon do. So, this attack is just like the other weapon's attacks. So is this one in terms of effect. But, oh, it also has very simple charge attacks, which are thankfully quite useful. That does twice attack plus a percentage of your attack, a random percentage of your attack. And this does three times attack plus a random percentage of your attack. And yeah, those raptors have pretty good defense, so really helps to get that charged up. And obviously this throw has a little bit of range with some fall off, and also has the, and notably by the way, stops after it hits one enemy. I think it does. Yeah, it does. Where the double charge has no fall off, moves faster, and will keep going after hitting an enemy. So, the spear is really, has really, really good charge attacks for dealing with distant enemies, as really your only ranged weapon, and use it in a couple places, specifically for its ranged attack. So, it is valuable in that. I don't need to step on that. Oh well, let's try this again. But more than anything else, more than anything else, the spear is really just a ranged weapon. And the only weapons that you can have that have better damage output are the swords. And clearly we do not have a sword at this point in the game, so I'm just gonna stick with the spear for the rest of this area. Damage potential, the really high damage potential of swords, is partly counterbalanced by the fact that the spear does more base damage. Even more counterbalanced by the fact that the spear can hit at a distance. There's some debate as to whether swords or spears are actually better, and personally I think it depends on the situation. Though axes are definitely the worst. Oh, shit. I'm supposed to be reading these. I had no idea what voice to give to this guy. So I'm just not gonna read it. We're never gonna see him again anyway. I'm not purchasing ingredients because I don't do alchemy. You can polykill with the spear. It's ridiculous that you can polykill with it, but, yeah, whatever. So is the way he throws the spear. Though that looks much better. And ultimately, nobody really expects realistic animations or effects. Or even animations or effects that make sense for being this old. Boom. Boom. Problem solved, let's move on. The swamp. One of the more maze-like areas. In the Prehistoria section of the game. In fact, I think it's really Prehistoria's only maze. By the way, up here is another one of these areas. If you've never played this game before, you're probably wondering what these have to do with anything. I assure you, they are important though. In fact, not only are they important, you really should remember where all of them are if you ever are going to play this game. Now, those of you who have played this game before know exactly why that is. Now, I'll give you a hint, by the way. The fact that I'm not really doing alchemy makes that substantially less neat. You could probably use a pedal. Don't want to waste a pickup. Again, sorry about the stupid sheet that I can't turn off. I didn't turn it on, I can't turn it off, and there's nothing I can really do about it. Thankfully, only the charms still remain. My character does not have infinite talents. He just has a crazy number of talents from all the grinding we've been doing. Oh, the reason why I don't need infinite talents is I do a lot of grinding. Not really mind grinding, it gives me more time with this game in the middle of my schedule, which, you know, is a good thing. I want to spend time with this game because I like this game. I pretty much know where to go out here. I'm not going to do too much, like, exploring and the like, because there's not really that much to find. This is one of those games where the point of the maze isn't to explore so much as it is to get lost. I mean, there is stuff to find, but not that good of stuff, and not at this point in the game. Later on, there'll be, like, alchemy formulas, which I don't use, hidden. There'll be alchemy ingredients, hidden, that I don't use. items, which I'm more or less good on, because I got this much money. So, that doesn't really do me any good either. Stupid frog. I hate these frogs. First attack is just so fast. Thankfully it doesn't do that much damage, but still. Talons. Because, you know, I really needed a lot of talons. These guys are best dealt with at range. I'm just not doing it because I'm trying to save time. Trying to save time and rushing it are synonymous. What I really don't get is why I can't walk up and to the left. I can walk up to the right. And that's not... And that, by the way, is not a problem with the game, that's a problem with the emulator. So here's the thing. I'm trying to get across here. But I had to kill that frog to do it. There's a roundabout way. Or I could just do that. Don't you love getting a cut to the chase? I think it's a call beat over there, though, if you want to go get that. I'm not going to go get that. Because I don't really need it. And now for... either a second or third boss, depending on how you count it. Bit of a wake-up call, too, because he's adorationless to your weapons when he's not attacking. This boss gave me so many issues as a kid. Not that I really... thing was even more hideous than the muck monster in the sickening of Slime City.
What a relief.
I need to figure out what voice to do for this guy.
What a relief. That beast is about to suck up my hut, and me with it.
I see you, it's time for that's it.
Thanks to you, it's on for sure. Good job.
No problem.
You can call me Blimp. I work the swamp gas and fume bugs.
Huh, that explains the stench. Classy.
I haven't noticed. Come on in, kid. I'll show you my place. Not the Great Caverns of Makanda, but it's home.
Well, if you like mud floors and mud walls and leaf floors, it's pretty nice.
I don't have much to offer in the way of thanks for saving my hut. But I'd like for you to have. That's not it. I can't see how this would be much use to you. Still beating heart. Nice, but not what you need. Please, take the smoked pepper.
Yeah, we came all the way out here for a fucking pepper.
Red pepper's a special quality. Another A formula. Come back and see me again if you use it up. Give you another one. Let the rest here for a while.
You were already full health, but why not?
You had a good rest. Would you like for me to record your progress? See you later.
Yeah, steel is water and water and water. I mean, he's in a swamp, he's got plenty. Granted, I think the water is supposed to be purified water, but again, he's in a swamp, he can just boil it. Let's get the hell out of here. Sorry to the, like, zero of you that really wanted to see me explore this area more thoroughly, but there really isn't much to find. There's a couple little deposits of alchemy ingredients, and I think a cauldron. Don't really need it. And I'd like to get a move on anyway. Now I beat him, there's a new thing unlocked back at Fireeye's Village. And I'll see you guys there. Oh, actually, yeah, I won't cut it until we pass the place. This is where you need to take the mud pepper to. Use this on that. Yep, and that's what happens. You move the rock. That's all you can use the levitate formula for, and the whole game is moving rocks. You do it a couple times, not just the one, but even so. So basically, just come back to this guy, and you can now buy new armor. Dino Home, Logard, I guess I'll buy the dog a collar. And, yeah, see, we're up from 4 to 7 there, from 3 to 6 there, and from 2 to 5 there, so Yep. Total of 9 more defense than the previous set. And having the better collar for the dog gives 5 more defense to him. Not that he really needs it. It's not like you're gonna lose because he went down. He's already pretty sturdy anyway. He's pretty sturdy, does good damage, but he can't cast alchemy spells, can't use items, and ultimately his damage output is lower once you get up to high skill with your weapons. Because his special attacks just suck. He becomes more powerful with each additional world you go to. Gradually at first, but the last area, he becomes really powerful. Not that it makes much difference if you have been using him to fight throughout the game. You don't really need him, because there's so many different little things that you use that are already game breakers in the last area of the game. But I need to. See how much damage this does. A lot of the late game spears with the final throw do more damage than the thunderballs. Channeling bazooka ammo that's not glitched. Just wondering, nuke this guy. All levitate this rock. There, by the way, is other places to go around here. Don't remember too many. I know that there's an alchemy formula you can get. I'll show you where to get it, but, I don't really... I'm not going to be using alchemy, so... the alchemy formula is a speed formula, which, I don't remember. I think it increases, I really don't know. Again, I've never been one for the for alchemy. I don't generally do magic in games. I mean, I do occasionally do magic in games, but I've always preferred, weapons to magic, as much as it was ever practical to do. I mean, obviously, magic is just so overpowered that you don't really have a choice, then I'm gonna stick to magic. Or, actually, for a few games, like Fable, I specifically avoided magic for that reason. System basically boiled down to press X to lose, press A to win, press B to win. Even then, you couldn't actually lose in that game. It's really more press X to take fucking forever on something that is not difficult because it's literally impossible to lose, or press B to win right away. Press Y for a middle option. You want to talk about a series that very definitely got worse? It'd be Fable. By the way, guys, if you're wondering, I am gonna do Secret of Mana after this game. I think I already said that, but just wanted to make that clear. And I may or may not do Seiken Densetsu 3. It isn't dependent on all that much. I just haven't decided yet if I really feel like it. I mean, I'm pretty sure I'll get to it eventually. It's just a question of when. The formula is actually inside one of the walls here. I don't believe it's in this room. It's actually, like, right over here on the other side. There it is. How'd you find me? I'm hiding here. I'm hiding from the vipers. We're going after the vipers ourselves. They're cooling down the outside world. Ah, so your couple of heroes are here. Good for you. Let me give you something for the challenges ahead. This is the speed formula. It'll increase your agility in battles. Makes you fun for quacks. I still have no idea what it actually does. I don't remember if it's like... I don't believe it's movement speed. I'm pretty sure it's movement speed. But other than that, I just do not recall. By the way, you sure can bypass a lot of the enemies in this... in these areas. Granted, I like to occasionally nuke an enemy just to get any of these guys. Doesn't seem to be able to do shit to stop it. Hey! Boom. There gonna be more idiots in here? No. Alright, now to get into a very quick fight. Just gonna ignore you, because you don't really matter. Boom! I said we might be overpowered. I was being facetious. We're overpowered. We are way overpowered. And now for the second maze. I completely forgot about when I said that the Prehistoria is only maze was the swamp. In fact, this is actually a considerably more maze-like area, a much more annoying one, but hey. That's just the cost of liking old school games, is you get stuck with a lot of maze levels. It's not that bad either. There's some games, there are a lot of older games, where you just get lost forever. This is not one of those. Thankfully. And let's get that move. Come over here, get nuked. Boom. Yeah, they only have 150 health. We are doing way more than that. Got him.
Thank you.
Yes! Da-da-da. Let's talk to this guy.
Ouch! Hey! Watch! I'm not going to hurt you. Not all vipers are savages. They're once peaceful, the desire for power is destroyed. Now there's some needed vipers and raptors in order to take over.
Are they leading the raptors?
Fight this force, maybe peaceful again. You like the mere gorgeous gardens?
Yes. I'm not doing any more of that.
See you later.
Okay. Now, I believe this is the place to go, right? Is that this right here? No. Was I even thinking? I don't know. Oh. That's what the raptor idiot is leading us to. Do ourselves a little favor. Pedal in. And head straight through. And now for the final boss of the area. And therefore the final boss of the episode. Sweet that we killed two bosses in the episode.
Inside the volcano, the temperature is dropping outside, because I'm cutting it off at the source. If the world freezes, my village will die out.
That's the idea.
Then my vipers and I can take control over your world. As much as I like to chat, sister, I've got work to do. So if you'll forgive me, I'm going to make it go away now.
That doesn't make sense. Wouldn't the vipers and raptors, since the reptiles were the first to be killed by an ice age?
Yep. This guy, by the way, does not have nearly as much health as the previous boss. But he does hit a lot harder. And he heals himself periodically. See how much you healed.
is substantially harder. Which he should be. He's the boss of the area. The final boss for this area. That feels good.
Okay, okay. You won the battle, Everett. Not the war. You want heat? I'll give you heat. So long, suckers.
Plausibly long fall from the waterfall. And the drowning. It should have been a drowning at least. What can't we survive? Oh man. Well, now I know a dandy Don Carly's felt like in Sink Boat Sink. Thinking about water in every orifice, pocket, and pore. You had it there before, didn't you? I mean, you're mostly made of water. No sign of Tacoma. Tacoma? Nope. Better look around. And I'll do that looking around next time. See all of you. See all of you next week, and take it easy.